there. There is other evidence that points to Nelson Mandela having already died, like the presence of the red blanket, as I explained earlier. Mandela's daughter, who was seen wearing a red blanket, and other family members were at the great man's gravesite. It is part of the Xhosa tradition that family members cover themselves with a red blanket when there's been a death in the family, not in preparation of someone dying, but only when a family member has died. I recommend that you guys go check these articles out for yourselves. And here I found another article, CBS News. The date, June 26, 2013. Nelson Mandela on life support. Here the article states that family members were observed inspecting a burial site in the area, and CBS sources told PATA the meeting was called to resolve a bitter family feud over the removal of graves and other relatives from the site by Mandela's grandson. A lot of other information in this article. Again, I'll put links below. As I continued digging, I found dozens and dozens of news articles reporting Nelson Mandela's death on June 26th and June 27th of 2013, over five months ago. And as I was digging, I came across this blog, a commentary on Nelson Mandela, written by Atia Maisoa, and I believe she lives in Botswana. But something that she said really caught my eye and really struck me here. And oh, the date of this post is June 10th, Monday, June 10th, 2013. And she says, although I am by no means hoping that Mandela will breathe his last breath soon, it will not surprise me in the least if his passing away is timed to occur precisely on a significant date, because believe it or not, such things can happen when your destiny is controlled by other powerful entities. Very insightful in light of the announcement once again of Mandela's death on December 5th. And here we have a video of Obama giving a tribute to Nelson Mandela in Senegal. And look at the date, June 30th, 2013. I'll play a short clip of this, but the audio is not very good, and the video, I'm afraid, is a little choppy, so I'll put a link to it in the comments section below.
Obama, President des États-Unis, Biden. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome President Macky Sall, President of Senegal, and this one.
For son premier voyage en Afrique, demain. So obviously our thoughts and prayers right now are with the people of South Africa, and more specifically the Mandela family. I will be traveling there over the next several days after I leave Senegal. I had the privilege of meeting Abiba and speaking to him, and he's a personal hero, but I don't think I'm unique in that regard.
If none of the reports you've just seen raise an eyebrow, that there seems to be a massive event going on to reprogram our memories of recent historical events, this next clip might wake you up. Nelson Mandela tribute, rest in peace, 1918 to 2013, Nobel Prize for Peace. I'll play a short clip of this tribute, and I'll place a link below for you to go view it in its entirety yourself.
for the healing of the wounds has come. The moment of bridge, the chasm that divides us, has come. The time to build is upon us. We have at last achieved our political emancipation. We pledge ourselves to liberate all our people from the continuing bondage of poverty, deprivation, suffering, gender, and other discrimination. We commit ourselves to the construction of a complete, just, and lasting peace. We understand it still that there is no easy road to freedom. We know it well, that none of us acting alone can achieve success. We must therefore act together as a united people for national reconciliation, for nation building, for the birth of a new world.
Did you hear that? For the birth of a new world order. Pretty nice tribute, huh? Except for this fact, and that is, this tribute was published on November 20th of 2013, nearly 3 weeks before the announcement on mainstream media that Nelson Mandela had died again. I think we should all be asking ourselves why. What is going on? Remember the very astute comment made by the blogger I pointed out earlier. She says, it will not surprise me in the least if his passing away is timed to occur precisely on a significant date, because believe it or not, such things can happen when your destiny is controlled by other powerful entities. Very astute. So, what else will be transpiring as a result of Nelson Mandela's re-death on December 5th? Well, first, we have Nelson Mandela funeral set for December 15th after 10 days of mourning. 10 days from December 5th is December 15th. It is being reported that 91 world leaders will gather in South Africa to attend Nelson Mandela's funeral. His funeral is being billed as one of the largest gatherings of global leaders in recent history. Representatives from around the world, prime ministers, religious leaders, dignitaries, kings, queens from all over the world will be attending in one place on that date. What else do we know is happening around this same exact time? Well, supposedly, if you're familiar with the gold and silver gates of the heavens that the ancients spoke about way back and before the time of the Mayans, the long count completes on December 16th, 2013, or the Mayan date of 13-13-13. And it is at this time that the sun is in the golden gate of heaven and the moon is in the silver gate, for a perfect astrological alignment. Now, let me explain this a little further here. On December 16th, the two gates, the gold and the silver gate, align with the moon and the sun. And that is supposedly the date at the end of the Mayan true calendar. The ancients universally accepted two portals or key dimensions into and out of the heavens. They were known as the Golden Gate and the Silver Gate. The Golden Gate was also known as the Gate of God, and it was the entrance into the heavens. The Silver Gate was also known as the Son of Man. The Son of Man. Ison? Don't know if there's a connection there. And was the exit out of the heavens. The Silver Gate's exact configuration is the constellation of Gemini and Taurus, intersected by the galactic plane with the galactic equator around the horns of Taurus. Now, I want to show you something also very interesting regarding the new Pope and his coat of arms. This is a picture of the Vatican coat of arms. And as you see here, there are two keys representing the two gates, the golden gate of heaven and the silver gate of man. And as you can see, they are bound together here to each other in a configuration of a cross or a crossing. And I'm going to try and explain this as best I can. The ropes or the bindings here represent the crossing through the dimensions into the other side. And on the silver side, it represents the crossing through the dimension out of the other side. And it talks about three portals through the gates here on the keys, as you can see. But I want to bring your attention to these dots here. Could these represent planetary alignments? I don't know, but I'm going to show you something very interesting in a video by Dabu7, and I'm going to put a link to his channel in the description box of this video below.
This is Dabu7 with an update to the December 16th Trinity that we have that took place between Venus, Earth, and Ison. Shoutouts to Base D77 for his work and a link which I will provide here. As the update, as we look here at this exact distance being the exact same as Earth and Venus with Ison on this day, if you look from this particular angle directly above our galaxy here, straight down onto the sun and all the planets, where you can see the perfect rotation from this particular view above in the heavens, looking down on everything, you get the perfect cross. You can see it on the JPL as well for the same date. You get the perfect cross when you add the sun.
There it is. You see it. Here are the points that are on the coat of arms for the Vatican. Just like in this video Dabu made using the JPL orbital diagram program. Interesting, huh? Remember in the disaster movie 2012, towards the end of the movie, they all were in the arcs, and the arcs were, after the disaster was over, headed towards South Africa, I believe, to meet up at